I have successfully recreated Autogen from scratch with the new OpenAI Assistants API. Here is their famous example featuring a chart of YTD, Meta and Tesla stock prices that was made by my system consisting of just two agents, a coding assistant and a user proxy agent. But the best part is that this system is much more controllable and customizable, which means unlike Autogen, it is actually deployable in production. I will show you exactly how you can add more agents to this system at the end of this video, so make sure to stay tuned for that. Let's get started. Alright, open the notebook from the description and let's install the packages, which are OpenAI and Instructor. If you haven't heard about Instructor, this is a library created by Jason Liu that allows us to define OpenAI functions as Pydantic schemas. This is an absolutely genius way to do this because it is much more convenient than JSON and also provides additional features like input and output validation. It is the only library that I consistently use in production when developing LLM applications, and we actually recently had a call with Jason, so hopefully we'll release some highlights soon. We will also create a small convenience function to print wrapped text outputs. Now, let me explain how the Assistant API works, because it is quite different from the previous chat completions approach. In this new API, there are threads that represent conversations, messages that represent individual messages within the threads, and agents that execute the threads to generate new messages. I know it can be really confusing at first, but the general process is as follows. First, you have to create an agent. Then, you have to create a thread. Next, you have to add a message to this thread. After that, you have to create a run for this thread with your thread and agent IDs. The big change here is that runs execute asynchronously, so you have to continuously check for updates until the run is finished. And finally, once that's done, the run goes into either the completed or requires action status. If it's incompleted, it means that you can safely retrieve the thread with the new assistant message, while if it's in requires action, it means that you have to run your function, pass the output back, and run the thread again to get the message. But to simplify the entire process and make it familiar for all of us who are so used to the previous version of the OpenAI API, I have created a function called getCompletion that essentially goes through all the steps that I have just described in a loop until the final assistant response is received. Check out the doc string for more details, because you might want to copy this function for your own projects. Now, let's go ahead and create our first code assistant agent, which will be responsible for generating and executing code locally. We'll begin with the tools that this agent will utilize, defined with the instructor library. The first tool, execute py file, will run an existing Python file from disk, taking a file name as a parameter. In the run function inside this module, we'll execute the file with Python 3 using the subprocess module and then capture any outputs or errors. Our second function, named file, serves to write the file onto the disk for later execution. Accurate description are crucial here, and as you can see, by using the instructor library, you can actually define them directly in the doc strings or the field descriptions associated with each specific parameter inside the model, which is extremely convenient. We'll also add an additional parameter, chain of thought. This is another ingenious technique introduced by Jason Liu. This parameter forces the model to map out each action step by step before proceeding with the function execution. This makes our agent more accurate on certain complex tasks without the need to use the chain of thought prompt globally as Autogen does, which significantly increases the token usage and latency in production. Next, we'll add both of these functions into an array to be used later in our getCompletion function and create our code assistant using the new Beta Assistants API. For the instructions, we'll state that our code assistant is a top-tier programming AI specializing in creating precise Python scripts. We'll also tell it to ensure that the code is executed before providing a response to the user. I decided to design this system by following a typical Kubernetes cluster architecture, where the user proxy agent is essentially acting as a load balancer that distributes requests to specialized individual agents and converses with them until the task is fully executed. Therefore, the only tool that the user proxy agent will need is a send message tool to send messages to other specialized agents. It has two parameters, a recipient and a message. The run call in this function actually calls our previous method getCompletion, with a separate thread for each agent, making our system sort of recursive. I say sort of because it has only one level of recursion after the main loop that also uses the getCompletion function. But I actually believe that recursion is the only way to achieve AGI because everything else implies that we have to provide predefined instructions to achieve the given task, which is not really general intelligence. As I said before, I will show you later how to create more agents. If this video gets a lot of views, I can turn it into an open source project and try to create an agent that creates other agents and tools. So please like this video and share it if that's something that you want to see. To ensure that our proxy agent has a separate conversation with each of the other agents in this group chat, we will store separate threads for each agent in a global object called agents and threads. Finally, we can define the user proxy agent itself with some instructions that you can check out on your own. The most important part here is that the user proxy agent must maintain ongoing communication with the other agents until the task is fully completed. The instructions that you pass to the user proxy agent have a huge impact on the behavior of the whole system, so definitely make sure to play around with that. To launch this system, simply create a new thread and start an infinite loop that prompts for a user message, gets a completion from the user proxy agent, and then prints a response. That's it. Now we are ready to test this system. I'll run it with a famous example from Autogen for creating a graph of stock prices for Meta and Tesla, starting with the first question: what is today's date? As you can see, the user proxy agent immediately calls the code agent with a given task. Although the first time it might not get the recipient name right, it immediately corrects itself and then the code execution agent starts to execute the file function. The function calls are displayed in red color and the function outputs are displayed in yellow. After the code assistant agent writes the code to the file, it executes it and returns the current date to the user proxy agent, which this agent then prints for us below. So, in this conversation, the user proxy agent converses with the other agents through the send message function. Basically, when it needs to chat with other agents, it calls this function with the message which the other agents then receive as the user message. After the other agent responds, we pass it back as the output of the send message function. This allows for a more natural conversation flow, where the user proxy agent can chat with the other agents as much as needed directly from the main chat with the user, just by calling this send message function. Let's try to run the second question. Compare the year-to-date gain for Meta and Tesla. Now, the user proxy agent immediately asks the code assistant to provide the YTD gain, and then the code assistant proceeds with creating the chain of thought prompt and writing the code itself. As you can see, it gets it on the first try and then returns the actual numbers using the YFinance library. For the final question, let's ask the user proxy to plot the stock price change and save it to the stock price YTD PNG file. After the code assistant executes the necessary code, the user proxy confirms that the file has been successfully saved. You can verify this by browsing the files on the left. As you can see, the resulting graph looks exactly like the one generated by Autogen. However, our system actually did it in far less tokens wasted. Nevertheless, there are a few things that you can still improve, which I'm gonna discuss next. First of all, this system does not currently support conversations between the agents that execute the tasks. It only supports the conversation between the user proxy with these agents. This is not necessarily a bad thing, however, because this improves the overall steerability of the system and helps to prevent infinite loops. However, you can easily adjust this by adding more threads into the agents and threads objects and also allowing other agents to use the send message function. Second, sometimes it feels like the user proxy agent still doesn't fully understand the instructions. I've played with the prompt for a little bit, but it could certainly use some improvement. And third, as I said before, you could actually make a tool for the user proxy agent that would allow it to create other agents and tools. If you could actually manage to do this, I believe it could lead to exponential growth and a complete humanity extinction in the next few months. Now, all jokes aside, let's try to add new agents to our system. To do so, first you have to create the tools that the agent will use using the pydantic schemas with the instructor library as we did before. To get started quicker, you can simply copy the code for the code assistant agent and replace any tools as needed. Then, add this new agent to the agents and threads objects and create the assistant using the new beta assistants API. You can also add out-of-the-box tools like web browsing and code interpreter. After creating your new agent, add its name to the recipient literal in the send message function and describe what this agent should do in the property description. Then, after running all the cells again, run the main loop and your second task execution assistant should now be live. In In conclusion, the best thing about creating custom agent swarms with the Assistant API is that they're actually usable in production. Unlike other multi-agent systems, here you have full control over the creation of new agents and tools. You can easily add any guardrails for your specific use case or even implement any custom logic, making this system easily steerable and adaptable. For instance, I decided to design this example with a single responsibility principle in mind. SRP is a common practice for building scalable systems that implies that each component should have only one specific responsibility. This allows you to easily add more components or replace existing components as needed. So let me know in the comments if you still think that AGI will be achieved with one superintelligent model and thousands of tools, or rather by scaling thousands of smaller agents together. And lastly, for those who need help building their own custom agent swarms, feel free to reach out to me. Thank you for watching, and don't forget to subscribe.